Hi, this is Jasmine from ENTTEC, and today's video is about how to connect your ENTTEC devices to the network. Understanding how to access your device's web interface can enable you to remotely configure its settings, and more importantly, it serves as a clear sign that the device is part of your network. You can easily access the web interface from any web browser within your network. Just key in the device's IP address into your browser's URL and voila. Stay until the end because we will give you a few troubleshooting tips and tricks if you forget or lose your device's IP address. Before we dive right in, if you want to hear more tips and tricks or just stay up to date with ENTTEC news and products and be notified when we go live, then hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a thing. Let's touch on networking basics. Each device on your network connected via Ethernet requires a unique identifier, or what we know as an IP address. There are two ways to assign an IP address. First is the Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, or DHCP, which automatically assigns unique IP addresses to devices on your network. For instance, your home Wi-Fi router, which is a DHCP server, keeps track of all of your active IP addresses and assigns unique ones to devices as they connect. On the other hand, a static IP address gives you the option to manually assign a static IP address for devices. This is especially beneficial for long-term installations as it guarantees consistent communication from one device that is unicasting to it, even if the power cycles. Now let's talk about subnet masks. You'll usually encounter 0 and 255 as common values in subnet masks. The value 255 fixes the corresponding IP address value, while 0 leaves it open to being between 0 and 254. For instance, if a device's IP address is 192.168.0.10 with a subnet of 255.255.255.0, it can only communicate with devices having an IP address ranging from 192.168.0.1 to 192.168.0.254, as the first three numbers are fixed, whereas the last zero is open. Similarly, an IP address of 10.0.0.60 with a subnet of 255.0.0.0 can interact with devices having an IP address from 10.0.0.1 to 10.254.254.254, as only the first number is fixed. This means that the device you are using to connect to ENTTEC devices and the device themselves must be within the communication range and have the same subnet address. All of the latest ENTTEC devices out of the box will be on a DHCP IP address as default, but if it is slow or absent, your device will switch to the default static IP address of 192.168.0.10 with a subnet of 255.255.255.0, which is written on the back of the device. This means that if you have a DHCP server, such as a router, it will provide all devices connected to the server an IP address within the same range. If you do not have a DHCP server, you will need to set your computer to an IP address with the 192.168.0.10 with a subnet of 255.255.255.0 range, such as 192.168.0.20 with a subnet of 255.255.255.0. If you have multiple ENTTEC devices and you are using static IP address method, you will need to connect one device at a time and access the web interface and assign the device a new IP address within the range to avoid IP address conflict. For example, you might end up with four ENTTEC devices on a network of 255.255.255.0 subnet, with IP addresses of 192.168.0.11, the next one 192.12, the next one 0.13, and the last one 0.14. Now, if you have your device's IP address, set your computer's IP address within the same range to access the web interface. For detailed guides on aligning your computer's network settings with your devices, refer to our Windows and Mac OS tutorials, which I have linked below. Happy networking! One thing I do recommend is putting a sticker of the device's IP address on the side of the device, which is easily accessible. So if it's in a rack, like the Storm 10 usually is, then people put it just over the device at the front. This means you'll have quick access to the device's IP address for future reference. So that only works if you're using a static IP address. If you're using a DHCP IP address, then if there is a power cycle, then it'll probably change. So then the IP address on the front doesn't match up. So if you're using a static IP address, then put a sticker on the front. Now, as promised, what to do if you lose or have forgotten your IP address on your device. So one of the first things that I recommend you doing is going onto the ENTTEC EMU software, which is a free to download off our website. It is a sound to light software, but it has a really cool feature where you can find, configure and update your ENTTEC devices using it. So jump onto that and then search for your device. If your device is on the network and it is searchable, then it'll come up and it'll tell you the IP address. If that doesn't work, then I do recommend trying the default IP address if you haven't changed the IP address. On a device such as the S-Play, you have the IP address on the LCD screen. So for a device such as the S-Play, just start it up and then it'll tell you the IP address that is on that device. We also have a reset slash identify button on some of our devices, such as the ENTTEC Octo and the new Storm 10. So with these devices, what you can do is you can try and find its IP address using a IP address finder, or if you really can't access the IP address because it just will not discover, you can perform a reset on the device. And it will go back to the static IP address of 192.168.0.10. Thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this video or you found it useful, please give us the thumbs up. And if you want to stay up to date with more videos like this or future unboxing live streams for new and upcoming products, then hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a thing. Comment down below if you have any questions or you think there's something that we've missed. You can check out our social media pages in the links below if you want more ENTTEC content, and stay tuned for more updates and more helpful ENTTEC tips.